Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to talk about how to find a remote tech job, and I'm going to give you places where to look for. And reminder, all of these links that I'm going to talk about are going to be in the description available there. So yeah, you can check them out after this video. Anyways, so let's start with all of the options that I have compiled where you could start your search for a remote tech job. So first place is actually job search sites or remote job boards. So these are the places where usually you can apply straight through the websites. These are sites like LinkedIn, Indeed, Glassdoor, RemoteCo, FlexJobs, WeWork Remotely, RemoteOK, and Working Nomads. All of these sites are places where jobs are posted and you can apply to. So a lot of the times the word remote is either in the title or somewhere in the description and you can find it, or maybe sometimes it's in down there in the little shrift written that there's option to work remotely, or maybe there's a percentage of remote work allowed. So usually these are the postings that you are looking for. In LinkedIn, there's also a possibility to actually select remote, but sometimes there's not a lot of search results. But when I try to search remote positions some type else, I find much more than using the remote location. I would advise for you to experiment around LinkedIn, for example, and try different variations of trying to search for the remote position. There's point number two, which is applying through company website. Now, a lot of the times, companies don't actually name remote possibilities in their job postings. A lot of the times they do, so it's like 50-50. But you should always remember, even if it's not mentioned, it doesn't mean they don't let you work remotely. You shouldn't get discouraged if a company has mentioned that they have a remote option. A lot of the times, companies are willing to negotiate on terms or something that you are looking for and they are looking for. They could negotiate your location or maybe some agreement between you two. Maybe you visit every 3 months. Maybe you don't visit at all. So yeah, try to apply through company websites. And also in this way, if you search for something, you actually search for something that you are interested in because you search for companies that you would like to work for. Example, like, I don't know, maybe you want to work for Spotify. So you go straight to the Spotify's website and apply for it. As in, when you're applying for random job postings, you don't even a lot of the times know what the product is actually about. So this way you actually can curate what your product and project is actually gonna be like that you applied for. Then there's freelance websites like Upwork and what is the second one? Free Fiverr. So yeah, you can apply through one of these, but I have actually been on those sites and it's very hard to actually sometimes get the jobs. I know people who have done it before and it takes a lot of work to actually build up your profile so you could actually get more gigs and then more possibilities as contractor would present themselves. But still, they are not crossed out, still an option that you could use. So point number four is actually QA curated websites for job postings like QA Jobs and Software Testing Help Job Board, which has specifically QA jobs available that goes for all the QAs that are looking for remote jobs. You can also try these places. And once again, even if it's not written there, remote somewhere, it doesn't mean that you need to rule it out. It's still a possibility. Then there's point number six, remote work communities. Remote work communities usually consist of everyone that works remotely. It's usually a huge web of people working on many, many different fields and they have very, very different knowledges all around. And it's great to network or maybe join some of the groups and just reach out to people. Maybe they know someone, maybe they could refer you somewhere else. They sort of know more how to look for these possibilities than probably most of us. So I would definitely reach out to someone maybe who's very involved in there and try out this way. Then there's number six, which is networking. And this is very, very great way to get actually a job. There's a lot of tech meetups all around, like everywhere. You just have to go there and start introducing yourself and maybe just get the word out that you're looking for a position. And, you know, the more people you meet, the more possibilities of someone actually knows someone that has that opening that you are actually looking for. Or maybe they are about to start something that they need you for and you would be a great fit. So you never really know what possibilities could come out of networking, and it's a great way to actually maybe find a possible job, or in general, even to your family and extended family. It's great to tell them, listen, I'm looking for a job, for a remote possibility. Maybe you know someone who knows someone. You never know, so you should definitely try it out. Then last point is number 7, which is recruiters. I worked with recruiters before, and I actually like this approach a lot because they sort of curate to your needs, and then they sort of find a company to you align with you with, so you would match, and it's something you're both actually looking for. Yeah, I would definitely try to befriend recruiters on LinkedIn and try to reach out to them that you're looking for a remote position. They usually have multiple companies that are working with them, so there's a lot of possibilities. And then last is basically my tips on all of this. I would definitely advise for you to really work on your CV. Get it like checked, not from a professional, but even just your family. Just show it to your family and ask them, do they think that it's actually any good? Do you feel like it looks professional and it has all of the key features highlighted and it's easy to see your achievements? Then I would definitely also be preparing already for the interview. You need to be ready to answer any questions if it's specifically something you are working for. And I actually have a video that covers QA testing, interview, CV, all of that right here somewhere. So go check it out after this video if you need any help in that. But in general, you really should be very prepared for the interview. You should not go unprepared there, and to be ready to actually get the position that you applied for. Then tip number 3, don't apply to every single one of job postings just because there's an opening. Find out what you're looking for. Like, write down on a paper what you're looking for. Remote is one thing, but what actually skills maybe you want to develop? What you want to expand more on? Can the company actually help you with that? These are the questions you should be actually asking the company in the get to know you interview part. See if you're actually aligned and it's something that would fit both of you. Then tip number 4, as I mentioned previously, just because it's not written remote there doesn't mean that there's no chance for you to get a remote position. I know a lot of companies are sort of open to discussing these possibilities, and especially if there's someone really skilled that they are looking for, they really, a lot of the times, don't care if they work remotely as long as the job is done. You should definitely be open. You should not shut down, you know, possibilities that you've never even tried. And tip number 5 is actually for LinkedIn. If you are applying through LinkedIn, you should definitely clean up your LinkedIn profile. Maybe ask your ex-colleagues or other people to help you expanding on your skills. I don't know. So usually recruiters search you by those that you've added there below, and just make your profile more presentable and, you know, all the information available there that needs to be known. Other than that, guys, I wish you good luck in your remote job search. I know it's not easy. There's been a lot of layoffs, as I read, but I definitely think that it's very possible these days to get a remote job. There's so many open positions, even if they're not mentioned. And if you never ask, you never know. So, good luck to you guys. See you in the next one.